Stomach again?
Hey, faster, I also need to pee.
For most of us, our business ends after a flush. But for this team of people, work begins after that. In this last episode, we meet the team of people who work behind the scenes to make sure what we flush away gets to where it needs to go. Let's discover how exactly our sewerage system works. These days, we don't think twice before we use the toilet. But was going to the toilet as easy as it is today?
No, of course not. I started living with the night salt bucket latrine from the day I was born. I make sure that I get up early and be the first one to use the night salt bucket latrine after it has been emptied. Then it's clean.
This is Mr. Chiang, who was involved in the Singapore River cleanup, and he's also one of the OGs who developed Singapore's underground sewerage tunnel. But we'll get to that later.
Oh, back then, of course, it was very polluted, you know, lots of debris in the river. One of the scenes that surprised me was to find people living under the bridges across the Singapore River. They just did the business discharging directly into the river. Last night's salt packet was removed in January of 1987 under the cleaning up program. Yeah. It was a historical day. Everyone was celebrating.
By 1992, the sewerage network expanded from just 810 kilometers in 1972 to 2,340 kilometers. And by 1997, all of Singapore had access to modern sanitation. So do you know how our sewerage network actually works? Firstly, when you flush, your sewage goes through your home's internal sanitary drain lines. This connects to others underground, and eventually, the waste is collected in public sewers that serve designated household areas. But what goes into planning the sewage pipelines for new buildings constructed in the area?
And that's where I come in. So the role of the planning design team is to ensure that we plan such that from the start of the network to the end of the network, there's adequate capacity to serve existing developments and the new developments. Internally, we have a set of formulas to use for different land users.
Wait, does that mean you have data on how often we use the toilet?
Well, there are ways to find out, roughly. We actually make use of the water consumption information to know how much water has been used by each household. And we assume that that amount consumed is the amount that will come out to the network.
Ah, I see. So once the pipes are laid, is the job done?
So one of the challenges is chokages within a network that's caused by items that people flush down. So examples of such items are sanitary pads, even wet wipes, Maggie Mee residue. Actually, you're not allowed to throw food waste into the sewage network. Some of our guys actually walk to the choke-prone areas, educate the residents to take note of items that shouldn't be flushed down into the toilet bowls.
From the public sewers, our sewage then moves towards Singapore's deep tunnel sewerage system. It's basically an MRT tunnel, but instead of trains, it's sewage that passes through. It works entirely with gravity, where used water makes its way to treatment plants. So Daryl, how far underground are we?
Now we are 60 meters below ground, the DTSS 2 tunnel.
Wow, that's almost as high as a 21-storey HDB!
So we are currently building DTSS 2, which will convey used water flow from the southern part of Singapore all the way to the western part of Singapore.
So if there's a DTSS 2, does that mean there's a DTSS 1?
Yes, there's a DTSS 1. It actually conveys used water flow from the northern part of Singapore all the way to the eastern part of Singapore. It's built by our predecessors, and Mr. Chiang is actually one of them. DTSS actually helps to free up space which will otherwise be used for water reclamation plants or intermediate pumping station. In land scarce Singapore, returning back the land to the authorities will allow for other useful developments.
Cool! And where does the DTSS lead to?
This is where the used water ends up. This is the water reclamation plant where I work at.
This facility is extremely important. It's where used water is treated so that we don't pollute water bodies and water sources meant for drinking, and in turn prevent the spreading of waterborne diseases. It's further processed to new water and utilized by the industries for various purposes. I find that the used water treatment process is a little bit like alchemy or even magic. Nobody wants used water, right? And you're converting it into something which is usable and a precious resource.
Singapore has progressed and advanced a lot in terms of sewerage, you know, from those days. And we have reached a stage where 100% of the population now enjoys modern sanitation. Not many countries in the world have achieved this, you know, 100%. So it's a great achievement.
In resource-scarce Singapore, we've had to be creative about the way we use our water and land. While most of these underground works go unnoticed, never take for granted the ease of sending our sewage away with just a simple flush of the toilet.